Right, we've got a Lenovo. This one is the model S145-15IWL. Okay, let's have a look. What have we got there? Oh, yeah, okay. Hey, let's turn these babies on. So let's check the charger. Volts. Charger is happy. Well, we get a white light. Do we? No, it's actually no light. So we don't need the benchtop power. Okay, so let's have a look. Trend micro. Nothing. Okay, let's have a look. What is this? i5 8th generation. Already don't have a good feeling about this. But let's not get ahead. Wow, excellent condition. Probably just a CMOS reset. We shall do it. So no one has worked on this yet. So this model can come with built-in RAM, maybe more RAM, and GPU, the VRAM. This system is as clean can be, so I think it's just going to be as simple as a CMOS reset. Batteries have not expanded. So this has that fancy Lenovo recovery. Okay, hold it for a few seconds too. Okay, so let's bring in the power and it should turn on. We should get a fan spin. No light. No light. Try recovery. No boot. Okay, try the power button. Nothing. Okay, so we can immediately see two MOSFETs and the shunt resistor there. So we should technically have 19 volts on the resistor here. Okay, we don't. How about then the pin? So our adapter is okay, the charging port is okay. Okay. Let's check the resistance on the shunt resistor. Hopefully it's a dead short. Nice, it's a dead short. So this will be an easy fix. Okay. See if we can locate it without removing it out of the board. We're going to come in with the short killer. Let me just relocate these screws. Like a crab. We're just going to inject 1 volt. Maybe even less, 0.9. Okay, 0.9 it is. Should be able to just inject like this and see where the short is. If it's on top, great, we can just replace it and Bob's your uncle. If it's a capacitor, that is. Okay, here we go. Where did it all go to? Nothing here. Wow. Don't tell me it's a CPU. Quick. Oh, okay, there we go. Okay. We found it. Thank you, short killer. I shall give you a nickname. Yeah, that's right, we did give you one. It was the hitman. Okay. Okay, let's go to the main screen. So it's coming from somewhere here. So let's switch over to our microscope. This guy, it's gone. Okay. You can tell by the coloring, he didn't have a good time there. Now, how can we remove this without damaging? I've got the world's crappiest. I'll try to see if I can use this guy. Shit, that's horrible. Okay. Let's try it anyway. Okay, here we go. It's heating up. So what we'll do is we'll apply some solder first. It's gonna be smelly. Done. This is my very old U, well, I think it is, crappy. Well, it does the job, I just need to learn how to use it more. Okay. Okay, let's put him away. Okay, so okay, let's turn him off and bring the onboard on-screen multimeter. Just gonna check resistance to ground on that shunt resistor. Now we're getting, as you can see, much higher, nearly a mega ohms. Okay. So what do we put in place? It's a good question. I don't know. What should we put in place? Okay, we have some board information there. That's what I need. Okay, so let's have a look at this. Shish, nothing. Okay, try FS441. Okay, maybe. What am I looking at? No. Nope. Okay, so a wrong board. Again, wrong board. NMC121. Okay, let's go through schematic then. Okay, so on board, this component is located on PJ5401. It's where it's connected to PU5401. Yeah, this should do it. PU5401. PU5401. Okay, good. And it's coming off pin number 10, I think. Let me double check. 2, 4, no, 10, 11, 12. Okay. 12. Power ground. Not really helping me. So let's do this. Let's do that. Okay, clear. Okay. So this chip. Make sure there's no power. Okay, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, okay. That's those guys are ground. Okay, 11. 9, 10, 11. Okay, pin number 11. Voltage in. Okay, so it's two capacitors. So we see three capacitors. Okay. 0603, 0603, 0402. So one of these guys is omitted. I think it will be 0603. These two are the same. It's going to be one of these 10 microfarads. Okay. Think. Okay, I think it's going to be these guys. Yeah, okay. Yeah, alright, okay. 0603. 10U, 25 volts. Okay. Copy that. Now we go back to our old tricks. We'll go and get another motherboard. Okay. Another motherboard. Okay. To a board that keeps giving. Okay. Let's do it like this. Okay. So this is a completely different motherboard, which have the code F115P. Okay. F115P. Yeah, I did open that previously. So the way they use naming convention for their capacitor. Okay, it's resistor, capacitor. Show me a cap. Okay. Pretty much. So they do the size later. You first. So we can do a search. U, right? Let's see if we can quickly find. The keyboard is far away. Okay. Paste. Okay. Just check another capacitor, same way. P, P, DC in. Just have a look some other places. P. Why do they use P? They use 0.2. You there. Anyway, let's do a search. Here we go. 6.3. We want, I think, 25. We can go underscore. All right, there we go. V-Buds, okay, so CT 39. Okay, so that's telling me the guy should be poor little guy here. Wow. You are our savior. Okay. Okay. Okay, that guy there. First, we should see if it is shorted. One side to ground. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, happy days. Okay, let's bring our board. Yeah, that's fine, we have only solder on one leg. We'll make it easier to put this guy in. I don't have a good angle. Ugly soldering, but okay, that will do. I mean, we could do hot air, but I don't want to melt the plastic on the other side. No point damaging it further. Hopefully, well, one thing I didn't check, oh, I don't need to check, maybe I should have. Let's check whether the cap I removed was actually faulty. What if it's not, and the short is still here, let's see. That's fine, okay. Alright, this problem is fixed. So many equipments just to fix one thing. I'm confident it will work. All right, do your magic, champ. That's if I get the right adapter. Should be. This one. Awesome. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. By the way, just check if the battery charges. Here, all the lights are good. Windows 11. Battery should be full. Yep, there we go. Nice photo. Awesome. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.